Oh, there's Madeline. Weird. It's. But I think I saw little Victoria a second ago. I miss Maddie. Good to see your name. I know you're still connecting. All right. So just pause for a few seconds. We've got a few more girls coming in, I think. And you can feel free to unmute your microphone. All righty. Awesome. Hi, Megan. How are you? Good. Hi. Oh, hi, Emma and Ellie. Good to see everybody. I saw Maddie just a second ago, but we'll see if she jumps back in. So, all righty. Ellie and Emma, good to see you. Good to see Megan. I think I saw little Victoria a little bit ago. We'll see. All right. So, Emma, you guys can go ahead and unmute your microphone, okay? And same for you, Megan. We're going to chat for a little bit here. I am at the dance studio today. Last week I was teaching in my house. That was something new for me. Well, did everybody have a nice Thanksgiving? Yeah? Yeah, tell me about it. Megan, tell me your highlight.
So originally we were not sure if I could go because our neighbors were exposed to COVID. But it turns out since they were asymptomatic, they could still go. So I got to be with one of my closest friends.
Okay. So I'm so sorry. You told a really good story just now. And is your mic all the way up? Because mine's all the way up. Okay. Yeah. So your friend thought they were exposed to COVID, but then they were not, and you were able to go?
Yeah.
Good. Well, good. And you ate some yummy food? Yeah. Ellie, tell me a highlight from your Thanksgiving.
Probably making gingerbread, decorating gingerbread houses with my cousins and family members.
Oh, nice. So do you have some finished houses in your home right now, or were you just doing the pieces so far?
Yeah, we finished them.
Okay. What about you, Emma? Something different?
Probably that one of our cousins got to sleep over at our house, and he's here right now.
Oh, very fun. Is your cousin older or younger?
Two years older. He's 2 years older, 1 year younger than our brother.
Okay. Cousin time is very fun. At my house, we had a lot of cousins, but they were only on Zoom. So there was me, Mr. Len, and our two kids. But then we had two family reunions, but they were only Zoom reunions. But it was nice to see everybody's faces. Good. All right. Well, I was just wanting to chat for a little bit. I think sometimes it can be challenging with connections because Madeline was there for just a moment and then her name disappeared. So I hope that she had okay internet connection there. So what do you girls have for a floor today? Are you on carpet or do you have yoga mats?
We have carpet and yoga mat.
Both? What about you, Megan?
I'm on carpet, but I can go grab a yoga mat.
Okay. Well, whatever you're comfortable with, okay? So if it ends up being just the four of us for acro today, we probably will be doing some tumbling because all three of you are kind of like intermediate students and you could do some things that I feel comfortable with you doing. So we'll do a little conditioning, then I'll lead you in some stretching, and then I'm gonna watch and I'll have all three girls work on your back walkovers and bridges from standing and that kind of thing, okay? I think that's it. And then Emma, do you girls know, is Zoe gonna log on today or is she, I think she's on vacation.
I think she might be on vacation, yeah. I don't know.
Okay, that's kind of what I thought too. I feel like she told me, but I have so much going on these days, I don't remember exact information. So, okay, and then I'm a little bit sweaty. Miss Zoe and I were just leading an hour-long fitness class. Like it was kind of a live Facebook event. So we just finished that up. We're like, oh, it's almost time to get ready for acro. So, good. Oh, yes, you have your hand up, sweetie?
We went to the fields and we played with our cousin for like 2 hours. And we ran around a lot.
Yeah, very nice. It was nice that we got some sunshine today so we could do that.
It was like 30 minutes ago that we went out. And
Okay, so your bodies are probably like all energized. Good. Alrighty. Well, I'm going to put some music on. I'll lead you in just some basic warm-ups, things to get your bodies loosened up. It sounds like if you've already been running around the field for 30 minutes ago, you're already warm. So we won't need to take as much time for that. We'll get right into the stretching after just one song then, okay? All right. All right, let's reach up. Wiggle fingers and thumbs. Hands open, close, open, close. One at a time. Side stretch. Two, three, four. Flat back. Two, three, four. To your left. Two, three, four. Center hold. Two, three, four. Heels go up.
Oh,
to our hands and knees. And lower yourself onto your tummy. Knees are bent. And reach, reach, reach. Stretch your back. Look for your toes. All right. Let's take one hand around, grab your foot, and just hold it. And change. Other foot. And let's grab both feet and lift. And round your back up, sitting on your heels. And tabletop, right leg through, reaching your splits. And other side, tabletop, left leg through, reaching into your splits. Keep holding the splits as I pause the music. Good. Okay. And then, Megan, if it's possible to change the angle on your camera, I'm going to have you do that because part of the class today, I'll be observing all three of you a little bit. Awesome. Okay. So how are we feeling about our splits, all three of you? And you guys can keep your mics on the whole time because we're going to be doing a little bit of talking. So these are some of the goals. We want to have three types of splits. Right leg, left leg, and then the center splits. Different teachers call it different things. I've heard it called Russian splits, straddle splits, Chinese splits. I just call it splits in second, but it's the one where the hips are square to the front. We want to be able to do all three of those. We need to be able to do a back bridge from a standing position and then stand back up with no support, no spotter. So one of the exercises that I have given to you in the past is, so can you guys hear me or am I, is it too soft?
We can hear you.
Okay, awesome, okay. So if you have a wall in your room, I mean, somewhere in your house where it's kind of like your mom doesn't mind you using it, you can walk your hands down the wall and come back up and just be doing that a couple times a day, but then start doing only your fingertips and then try to just come up without even touching the wall at all. But that's a safe way to do it if you don't have someone there to spot you. But once we've mastered those basic tricks, there's a lot of tricks that we can start to do, okay? So for the purpose of today, we're gonna focus on those three types of splits and then increasing your back flexibility. And it's one thing to have a flexible back that you can get there, but you have to have a strong back so that you can actually stand back up without someone helping you, okay? Since it's only the three of you, we probably won't run through the Christmas choreography today. And I thought our numbers would be down because of being Thanksgiving weekend, but I'm really thankful that the three of you are giving me your Thanksgiving Friday for class, okay? So let's start. Megan, if you can kind of put the camera just on yourself, can we see your right side splits?
Yeah.
Awesome, okay. So those are really great splits, and then I'm gonna pick on just some tiny little things, okay? So you wanna make sure that the right big toe is not turning towards the mat. The leg should be turned out, yeah. And then our hips, okay? Our hips are like square. We wanna make sure that the hips are not that way when we're in splits, but they actually should be square forward. So you've got one leg front and one leg back, okay? But you are all the way down, and it's lovely, okay? Ellie, let me pick on you next. Can you show me your right side split?
Yeah.
Nice, okay, very, very good. So I'm gonna, and you've got a nice turnout in the front. What I'm gonna ask you to do is work on reaching, reaching, reaching behind you with the left leg as much as you can, okay? So you keep working on that while I watch Emma, okay? Emma, can you show me your right side split, please? Oh, and Ellie, go back to holding yours, my dear. Okay, nice. Can you point your toes in front? Good. It looks like you're rolling onto your right hip, so try to push into the left leg. There you go, good girl. Okay, beautiful. All right, keep stretching. Megan, show me your left side split, please. I know, that's why I had to come to the studio to work, because Asher won't let me teach from home. Nice, okay. Yeah, it looks like your form is really good. You got about this much before you actually hit the floor. Can you take the arms to second? Beautiful, okay, good. Okay, Ellie, I'm gonna pick on you. All right, left side splits, okay. All right, just think about really reaching through the toes of both legs. Slowly those legs are gonna open up, okay? Good girl, okay. Emma, show me your left side split, please. Good, all right, reaching, awesome. Good, okay, excellent. Okay, Megan, straddle splits. Nice, good, okay. I appreciate your form, very nice form, good. Okay, so I would say for straddles, the way that it's gonna keep opening, just kind of sit in a place that's comfortable to you. Keep your hands in front of you, even if you're just like maybe playing a game with your phone, with your friends or something, you can just be rocking forward, just really gently. And it's just a really gradual thing, but eventually you're gonna look and you'll be like, oh my goodness, my legs are in a complete, like straight straw. Okay, because your form is really good, you just need to be gently scooting forward with that. Okay, Emma, show me your straddle splits, please. Okay, put your hands on the floor in front of you. Yep, nice. Okay, I'd say the same as I said to Megan. You can be doing that anytime at home, watching TV and that kind of thing. Just kind of keep scooting forward onto your hands as you're doing that. Okay, Ellie? Hands in front of you, lean onto the hands. Okay, good, perfect. So all three of you do have very good form for your straddles. And so all three of you, that's gonna be your homework, is just to be kind of scooting forward, putting your weight onto the hands as you're stretching. Okay, let's work on our backs. So go onto your yoga mat or whatever you've got, and you want to be able to, at your house, you should see yourself in the middle of your screen. Okay, whatever box wherever you're watching the screen. And so for the twins, it's gonna be tricky because I need to see both of you at the same time. But I think if you move back away from the camera a little bit, I'll see you, okay? So you're gonna be on your tummies, but wherever you are, you should be in the center of your screen, okay? So lay out your mats in such a way that way I'll always see you on screen. And Megan, you're gonna take your purple mat and take it a little bit farther to the wall behind, a little farther backward. I know I'm being so picky today, I tell you. Perfect. Okay, awesome. Alrighty, so go ahead and put your chest down on the floor. Everybody bend your knees, toes to the sky, and we're going to stretch, straighten out those elbows, look for the toes, and put them on your heads. Go. And if you're not touching the heads yet, just keep trying, keep reaching. Because our bodies are warm, and all three of you have beautiful flexibility. Awesome, and come on down. Good, good, good. Okay, this is so fun and it's so interesting that the three of you logged on for class today because you have very, very similar flexibility. So we're gonna be able to work on some of the same movements, okay? At any given time, everybody has permission to give yourself a break. You can kind of like go like that to loosen up your back, but we're gonna stay with back flexibility for a little bit, okay? So this time, can you make the banana boat where your knees are bent, you grab the tops of your feet and lift, okay? For all three of you, you should be able to pull those feet onto your shoulders. Beautiful, Megan, that's great. Yes, good. Awesome, okay, think about lengthening your necks, girls. That sounds really silly, but you know, in ballet we say long neck. That's gonna help your back flexibility also. Perfect. Alrighty, relax. All right, now come onto your backs and let's work on our bridges from the mat, and then we're gonna go move into back walkovers, okay? So hands under your shoulders, heels by your bottoms, and push up. Looking at your hands, hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Straighten the knees if you can. Push, push, push to straight knees if you can. Gorgeous. All right, come on down. You can give yourself a little rock and roll. Rounding it out. Okay. Alrighty. So Megan, I know that you already have your back walk over and you already have your flip-flop, so I'm gonna give you a little bit of extra work, but just for a minute, Ellie and Emma, I'm gonna have both of you go into your bridge. And if Miss Debbie says, develope the leg, what does that mean to you?
Point the leg up.
Yeah, so it goes like the knee and then the arm. So you develop it out. So one leg's gonna be extended up in the sky. Okay, so everybody go ahead, push into your bridge, and we're gonna have right leg up. Push, 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 nice bridge. Développé the right leg, hold it up in the sky. Gorgeous. Bring it down, développé the left leg up to the sky, really reach, 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 pushing, 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 working towards a split, like a vertical split. Bring that leg down, and first leg, développé it up. Stretch, 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 push it to the sky, working towards a split. Bring it down, and second leg, développé up, working towards your split, and down. Good. Okay, take a little break. This time we're gonna try to make a donut, okay? We're gonna make a circle with our bodies. So you'll be in the bridge, and you're gonna walk your hands in. Okay, last week we were doing this on Zoom, and I think both, Maddie was one of the girls, I think Senna was the other one, that actually walked her hands in and grabbed her ankles, okay? We don't want to do something that hurts, but go ahead and challenge yourself to go as far as you can. See if you can tap your heels. If it doesn't hurt to tap them, then try grabbing your ankles. Straight arms if you can. Nice, beautiful, wonderful, Megan. Wow, wonderful. Okay, alrighty. And then Emma and Ella, do you have two yoga mats or one yoga mat?
One yoga mat.
Okay, so I'm gonna have you guys share. We're gonna start working on back walkovers, okay? And you guys can watch for just a second. Megan, you can remind me, you do back walkovers with no spotter already, is that correct? Yeah, okay. So if you're okay, could you go ahead and demonstrate one? So girls, go ahead and watch Megan, and I'm gonna talk you through it after she does this. Okay. So from a standing position, she's reaching into her bridge. She développés the leg. Isn't that pretty? Okay. So you can do it from a standing position. You can also do it from the floor, the way we've been practicing. So Megan, if you don't mind, I'm gonna have you work for a little bit on your back walkovers and then try your second leg, which I know isn't your favorite one, but just work on that. Emma and Ellie, you're gonna go one at a time. So whoever wants to go first, push into your bridge. Go ahead, yep. Développé your leg up into the air and then just start to try to kick it on over. And kick. Yep, and kick. One more, and kick. Good, that's it. You can come down out of your bridge and let your sister try it. That's the way we start, okay? Pushing into the bridge, looking at your hands. Développé one leg into the sky, and kick. And again, and kick. And again, we kick. And one more time, and kick. You're doing a little jump as you kick. Good, and come on down, good. And I know we feel awkward and we feel silly because we end up falling sometimes, but it's not a problem. That's how we learn things, okay? Nice job. All right, you doing okay, Megan? Okay, could you try a flip-flop for me? Two legs at the same time? Yeah, I'm being so mean. It's hard to teach on Zoom. So girls, watch this. When she's gonna take both legs at the same time, but she's gonna do just a little jump. Then Zernie said she jumps. And she bends and she jumps and bends and jumps. Cool. Okay, good. That's perfect, Megan. Thank you. Okay, so when we do a back walkover, it's one leg going over at a time. When we do what's called a flip-flop, it's two legs at the same time. So probably both of you girls can work on that together. You don't really need a yoga mat. You'll just be in your bridge and try to kick both legs over at the same time. Okay, it's just like a little jump, but you're upside down. Okay, all right, Megan, ready? Do you already have your front limbers? Yeah, okay. Can you go ahead and do one of those for me? And then Ellie and Emma, I want you to work on the bridge with the double leg kick. Go ahead and go to work, girls. Beautiful, okay. So Megan, I'm gonna ask you to do it in what I would call slow motion, because now what we're gonna start to work on is controlling the handstand. So try to stay in the handstand just like a half inch longer before you drop to the bridge, okay? So you just kick up really slowly. Nice, good. Keep going. I like how you're controlling that. Nice. Nice, okay. Try putting your hands onto the mat first, and then just kick onto your hands. That'll slow it down for you, okay? There you go, good. Yep, hands on the mat first. Nice, okay, very nice. And then, so what I'm mentioning, because you're still going from a standing position, I would literally just go like this. So I've already got my hands down. Then I kick from there. So you got solid weight on those hands before you go. So go ahead and try it like that. So put two solid hands down on the mat and then kick. Yes, bend your knees. Yeah, there you go. Just keep trying it like that, because that's gonna slow you down, which is what you need to do, good. Good, keep going. And Ellie and Emma, you guys can try that one too, actually. Just put your hands on the mat and try to slowly changing the weight onto your hands, just kicking it up. Because we wanna try to stay on our handstand as long as we can. Megan, you're doing great. Yeah, just so bend your knees to kind of start almost in a squatting position. That's going to give you more control. Yes. And straight from the squat, try to lengthen out those legs. You're doing just great, sweetie. Good. Good. Awesome. Okay. So everybody's got pretty good balance today. We're pretty warmed up with it. We're going to try, this is almost like a little circus trick, but once you master this one, you can do it in so many different formats, but we're going to go into an elbow stand. Okay. So I've always been saying spread those fingers out so that you've got a lot of balance on your hands, but this is going to give you space from here to here. Okay. So we've done a lot of planks and we've done things like this. But now what we're going to be doing is just on our knees, we're here, and then, okay? So just like you did with handstand, try to keep, you got to arch the back a little bit, and then you're balancing on your hands, okay? So kind of play with that a minute. I'm gonna grab my mat, I'll be right back. Good. Yes. Oh, Megan, that's so good. Okay. Yeah. And so Ellie and Emma, what's a little bit tricky, because you girls are trying to face each other, you have to arch your back when you're doing an elbow stand. So there's a big chance that you're going to kick into each other. So it might be better if you just kind of take turns. Or this is a safe exercise for you to do on the carpet. You don't even really need a mat for this one. Okay. Awesome. Okay. So often when an elbow stand happens, it actually, you'll see a girl and she's like on top of a guy's shoulders, or there's one person and they're doing this, and then she does an elbow stand on top of their back or something. So it's prepping for doing things in partnering, okay? So try one more time. I'm just gonna call on you one at a time. So let's start with Ellie. Show me your kicking into an elbow stand. Nice. Okay, yep, palms on the floor. Arch your back. You're gonna keep looking at your hands, so you end up arching your back. Point your toes. Good. And then, because you've got a really flexible back, if you end up kicking on over and you end up in kind of a back bridge, that's totally fine too, okay? Emma, go ahead and give it a try. Elbows down, arching the back, and kick up. Keep looking at your hands. Look at your hands. Kick a little farther. Think about going all the way over to your bridge. A good girl. Do it again. So close. Do it again. There you go. Okay. Megan, give it a try. Nice. Keep going. Hey. Wow. Have you done that before, though? Amazing. Good for you. All right. Well, you know what? We're on to something, so I'm not going to move on quite yet because I think all three of you will potentially just do it then. Okay. Ellie, show me again, please. Palms pressing into the floor. Look at your hands. Look at your hands. Okay. Now start kicking up. Arch the back. Point the toes. Kick higher. Keep going. You can do it, girl. Keep going. Kick, 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 kick. Yeah. One more, one more. It's okay, we're all girls. Okay, good. Emma, show me. Palms flat on the floor. Yep, keep looking at those hands. Kick towards your sister. Good, you got a nice straight body. Good, 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 good. Keep going. Kick a little harder, a little farther. You can do it. Hey! Have you done that before? I love it. Here we are. We're on TV, we're on Zoom, and you're mastering new things. Okay, Megan, you're up again. Looking at the hands, nice control, beautiful. Nice. So Ellie and Emma, if you girls can see the way Megan's doing it, you have my permission, especially because there's two of you, you can be helping each other. You can work on that trick during the week too, okay? Once you can do a front limber from an elbow stand, it's gonna be a lot easier to do it from a straight arm too. So you'll be able to do both. The minute you can do a front limber from elbows, you'll be able to do it from your hands also. Okay, nice. Let me see your headstands. Let's all start with a tripod, okay? Hands in place, head at the top of the triangle, knees on your elbows and toes up.
Should one of us do it?
What's that?
Should one of us do it or should we both do it?
I think we can all go at the same time. Yeah, okay. Give that room. Good. Okay, so does everybody feel really comfortable with tripods and headstands?
Okay. Yes.
Okay, can you leave your mic on or did your mom prefer that it's off?
Nah, you can leave it on.
Okay, that way it's easier for me to talk back and forth. Okay, so the reason I asked if all three were comfortable with doing the tripod, because again, I'm gonna give you permission. There's quite a few tricks that, since it's the three of you today, you have permission to work on things at home, okay? Sometimes I have a class of mixed levels and I never wanna have one or two girls feel bad if some people get to move on and others do not, but all three of you, you have my permission to work on back walkovers, front walkovers, cartwheels, headstands. Okay? Good. All righty. So let me see Emma go from tripod to headstand. You're up. Put your knees on your elbows. Go slowly, toes up, and then slowly grow. Toes reaching towards the sky. Good girl. Hold your tummy tight. Nice, okay, perfect. Okay, so you can work on that at home. Always start with the tripod and then grow the legs going straight up. That's very good. Okay, Ellie. Just go slow. Hold your tummy tight, toes off the mat.
Hold on, I gotta take this sweatshirt off.
Okay, sure.
Get
warmed up. Good, okay. Your tripod is very solid, and that's the main thing. Once you've got that, just keep trying at home and hold your tummy nice and tight. And even if you just grow a tiny, tiny bit, that's great. And then the next time you go a little farther, and next thing you know, maybe by next Friday even, you're gonna show me a full headstand. Okay, Megan, you get a bigger challenge. You're gonna do tripod, headstand. Once you get there, drop the legs into the split and close and come back down. Okay. Go slow. Nice. Okay. That's all right. We always want to be working just a little bit farther than what we're comfortable with. Okay. I'm going to have you keep working on that for just a minute. I'm going to come back to you while I work with the twins. Okay. What I noticed too, Megan, you know, I get to pick on you because I'm the teacher. When you went into your headstand, it wasn't like that. It was more like your legs were there. So then it was time for them to straddle. It's like that's why you fell back down because you weren't quite straight yet. So you want to feel like your hips are just on top of your shoulders. Okay? So concentrate on that. Okay, Ellie, let's see you go again. Yes, good. Top of the triangle. Nice and slow. The knees meet the elbows. We're solid. The toes leave the floor. We're solid. The tummy's really tight. And then when you're comfortable, the knees are going to leave the elbows. Just the tiniest bit. Good. Yes, yes, yes. Good. Emma, let me see ya. Same thing as what your sister did. Nice solid hands on the floor. Head at the top of the triangle. Nice and slow. The knees meet the elbows. Nice and solid. Tummy's tight. Toes leave the floor. And when you're comfortable, the knees leave the elbows. Just a little. Yes. Wow. Wow. Hey, girl. All right, come on down. Okay. Do you feel okay? Are you dizzy or anything? Okay, so I'm gonna give you the same assignment that I gave to Megan, okay? Did you see what Megan is she's having to work on? Once she gets into, okay, here, I'll demonstrate it, okay? So Megan's doing tripod, headstand, straddle, headstand down. So hands, head. Okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, you work on that, and I'm going to talk to Megan for a few minutes, okay? All right, Miss Megan. Are you okay? Are you dizzy at all? Or?
No.
Okay. All right, show me your headstand straddle, please. Ellie and Emma, you girls can keep working too.
Working on what? The tripod?
Yeah.
Okay. The headstand straddle. The same thing that Megan's doing, yeah.
I don't think we have enough room for me to do that.
Yeah, you guys can, you can just kind of go back and forth and share. Yeah. Okay. Oh, so close, Megan. Okay, so everything's there. I think you need to hold your tummy a little tighter, okay? So, I don't know, I use my hands a lot, okay? But when we're in a headstand, we want to feel, it needs to look like that, but it's actually going to feel like that, okay? Because there's my tummy. I'm going to pull my tummy in, and that's going to help me get control so I don't flip on over to the other side, okay? So you're going to be straight up, but because you're holding your tummy so tight, it almost feels like you're piking a bit, okay? So try it again. Megan, while you were upside down, one of the twins was doing it too. So this is exciting. Okay. Is your neck hurt?
No.
No, okay. I always have to watch every sometimes like someone's playing with their hair and I just want to make sure there's not an injury, but awesome. Okay. So I want to tell you guys a secret, okay? This seems like kind of like maybe kindergarten materials. Like, wait a minute, Miss Debbie even has the toddler tumble kids doing headstands. But this is important, okay? Because when our necks are strong and the muscles around our back, like you don't want to ever hurt your spine, but the muscles around your spine have to develop. So when we're solid with a headstand, that's going to help you get ready for so many other tricks, okay? So this week, this is your homework between next today and next Friday, the right splits, left splits, straddle splits.
Got it.
The back bridge from a standing position. If you don't feel comfortable doing standing position, you don't have to because I don't want anyone to get hurt. You can do it from like pushing off the mat, okay? The other one is the tripod to the headstand. If you know those five tricks, by the time we get back to the studio and we're all together and I can spot you, you'll be able to move on to so many different tricks, okay? So please don't get impatient with yourself or with me and think, why is Miss Debbie making us do a baby trick? It's really not a baby trick, okay? If you can control your tripod and control your headstand, you're ready for a lot of things, okay? Alrighty, now let me see. Megan, you definitely do your bridge from standing position and like you drop to it and stand back up? Yeah, okay. Ellie, I'm gonna have you do it, but I'm gonna talk Emma through how to spot it. Or is your mom right over there off camera?
No, but I actually a couple days ago, not weeks ago, when we still had, when we weren't online, I did it, so I've been okay. Able to do it.
The reason I asked that, I knew you guys kept looking to the side, and I wasn't sure if you were looking at the screen or if your mom was there. But
our little cousin was over, so.
Okay, alrighty. So I'm going to talk you through it, okay? So whoever wants to go first, let's say Ellie, you're going to go first. I want you to stand at the bottom of your mat. So the part of the mat that's closest to the camera. Oh, you're sideways. Okay, that's fine. So stand at that side of the mat. Yes. Okay. And turn and face the other way. Okay. Hold on. Wait for your sister. Okay, sister, come on in. Okay, so Emma, look at Miss Debbie's hands. You're gonna go to the side of your sister and put both your hands like on her back, okay? And go to the other side so that I can see you better, please. There you go. Okay, good. Ellie, hands up. Look at your hands. Emma, keep pushing right into her back. You gotta hold her. Yes. Okay, put your chin on your chest and come down. Okay, so girls, look at the camera. I need to see both your eyes. Okay, so that was very, very good, but you actually, it's not just like touching your partner. You got to use your muscles. You got to push into her, okay? So when your hands are on her back, you're her lifeline, okay? It's not like, oh, I'm going to tickle her. It's not tickling. You got to use your muscles and push right into her back so that when she drops down, if by chance her arms aren't ready to catch her, you're holding onto your sister. Okay, let's switch it. Okay, ready, Emma? Look at your hands. Ellie, use your muscles and push both your hands into her back. Yes, yes, yes. Wow. Okay, lower yourself down. Okay. So both of you girls have my permission to practice that this week. Between today and next Friday, you have to spot each other, but you're both doing it beautifully. Yes, you have your hand up.
I already know how to do a backbend without help.
Do you do kickovers?
No, but I can do a backbend into a bridge without any help.
Okay, thank you. So I want both of you to do that 5 times every single day between now and next Friday. And then next week, we can start getting ready for the back walkovers there. So you can do a kickover. Okay, lovely. Okay, we've got 10 minutes. I feel like those 5 basics is just what I want to focus on. And so when all 3 of you are really solid with that, because since I can't be there to spot you, I need to know that I can feel comfortable. You're going to, okay, so let's kind of go back to the beginning really quick. Show me your right leg split. Everybody go. Try to be all the way down. Hips need to be square to the front. Toes are pointed. The left leg's reaching back behind you and arms in second. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Change legs. Left leg forward, right leg back. Hips are square to the front, toes are pointed. Right leg is reaching back behind you. Arms in second, holding. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Straddle split. Leg in second, hands on the floor in front of you. Lift yourself up and scoot your torso forward. Move your hands out, lift yourself up, scoot your torso forward and drop yourself down. Can't move your hands up. Try not to let your heels move. Your heels have to be glued into the floor. Hands in front of you. Lift yourself up and scoot forward. Elbows on the floor. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Okay. I see improvement from where you were at 40 minutes ago. So I love it. So I'm going to give you some splits homework now, okay? I got to go get my prop. I'll be right back. Okay, so this is my dance bag, but you can use anything. You can take your yoga mat and roll it up, or you could like maybe take a stack of books. So I'm gonna take my dance bag, it's on my mat, and I'm gonna do my splits, but my one leg is gonna be on the dance bag, okay? So then I sit down, so my leg is not flat on the floor, it's actually higher. So instead of my splits being like this, my splits are like that, okay? Now, when I explain to you, that's called an over split, and you might say, why would I ever need an over split? You need it so that later when you wanna do a split leap in the air, or you wanna do something that really, it requires extreme flexibility, it's great to do your split, but it's better to do an over split. So Miss Debbie's always asking you to be flat on the floor, but now for the 3 of you, I want more than that. I want you over split. Okay? So, yes.
We have this. It's flat on the back.
Yes, yes. That is absolutely perfect. That I have kind of one of those yoga rollers at my house, and that's what I use also.
We have a half roller and a roller. Yeah, it's a half roller, so okay. It's flat on the ground.
So for now, start with the half roller, but very soon, you're going to need the full one, okay? Because That thing only lifts you up about this high, but the full one's going to lift you up like that. Megan, do you have anything that could be a prop like that?
I have a full roller.
Perfect. Okay. So those are safe tools for you guys to be working with. So again, I'm giving you a little homework between now and next Friday. Okay. Please show me. Okay. We did all the splits. Okay. We got our homework for the oversplits. Let's see how we're looking for the bridge. Push into the bridge and walk your hands towards your heels the best you can. Looking at your heels, looking at your hands. We're going for a full circle. Keep pushing your tummy towards the sky. Nice. Beautiful, beautiful girls. Good, good, good. Okay. Okay. So for Ellie and Emma, your homework this week is push into your bridge every single day and try to also do it from a standing position. Okay. And I know that you kind of have that already, but just do it every single day to get it stronger. Megan, your homework is try to do the double leg kick from your bridge. Okay. Excellent job. Alrighty. For all three of you, and Megan already kind of has it mastered already, but we're also going to do the headstand, open to splits, close, and come back down. Alrighty. If you do have trouble balancing with that, believe it or not, what you need to do is more sit-ups. Do you guys know what sit-ups are? Yeah. It strengthens your abdominal muscles, because sometimes when we have trouble balancing upside down, it's because of we have to do core strength. So the remedy for that is this exercise, and then also lots of those, because these are the strong muscles you need for your headstands, okay? So I'm sorry to give you homework, but we're all at home in quarantine anyway, so it gives you something to work on, okay? So do you kind of understand what the assignment will be for next week? Okay, hopefully we'll get everybody back online when the holiday is behind us, and then we'll go back to working on the Christmas dance. Our goal is December the 19th. It's a Saturday afternoon, Willis Tucker Park. We're supposed to have black leotard, black leggings, and then you can wear whatever you want to on your feet. But right before you go out on stage, we're going to be going barefoot. And then I'll give you some hair ribbons, and we want to have like a warm, cozy Christmas sweater. Yes, you got your hand up? Yes.
Question.
Yes.
When it's Christmas, will we have that week off?
Yes, and it's interesting. Actually, we talked about just going right through Christmas, because usually we have a 2-week holiday, but we've missed so many things this year. We were going to go right through, but honestly, we don't know. We have to wait to hear from the health district and hear from the governor when we can legally reopen the doors to the studio. So if it's only on Zoom, we'll just take the week off, because, you know, we all have so much screen time as it is. I would prefer that you guys go skiing or go outdoors and don't look at me on screen anymore. But I'll let you know that week. So we'll have our show on the 19th, and then we'll have at least 1 week off, but it might be 2 weeks off. We'll wait and see how the quarantines are looking at that point.
So if things don't open up on the 19th, will we not have it?
I think we'll still be able to have it, because it's an outdoor performance. The issue is we're not allowed to do indoor gatherings right now, but for outdoors, it should be okay.
Okay.
All right, good. Any other questions? Or?
No.
I'm glad that y'all had a happy Thanksgiving. I'm glad to see you today. I miss getting to see you face to face, but just enjoy your weekend and stay creative. And I'm sure I'll see Megan on Zoom on Monday, and I'll see you girls next Friday, if not before. Okay. All right, well, we're done for today. Great job. Super duper job.